Okay, so then this is helping a bit. It's helping a lot, actually. So then there was like a lot of different things that I was thinking and feeling. And one was, I'm really fucking proud of us. Oh my god, there's so many things at once. It's a lot. It's a lot, and we're doing really, really fucking well. Amazingly well. We're safe. Okay. I wanna just like rattle off everything that just hit me at once, and I want to address every single thing slowly, and I don't know how to mix those two things at exactly the same time. Okay. I'm really proud of us. How we decided that we're going to, like, we decided a long time ago, like a year, like 2 years ago, we discussed how we would respond to comments that were like ignorant assholes, and we were like, you know, trolls exist, people that don't understand mental health exist, it's the internet, basically. We had the it's the internet discussion, and the what are we going to do about the fact that it's the internet, and how we decided to deal with it is very much how we're dealing with it, and it's actually working in the way that we thought it would, and I'm really fucking proud of us, and like really, really amazed by that. I'm in awe, and I'm like really fucking shocked and impressed with us. Because I had very imposter syndrome about it in a lot of parts of me when we were discussing it. And a lot of like, this isn't real because, or this won't work because, or like, we won't really be able to do this. Not that I realized I was thinking those things, but like, I just realized that I was feeling that way whenever we discussed like how we were going to deal with it. And I really am starting to see now that, like, the imposter syndrome must be going or something. Because I'm really starting to see that we are genuinely who we believe ourselves to be. I'm getting a sense of self, and I like the person that I am. I fucking adore the people that I share a system with. I really adore every single part of me and of us, and I can see that we are true to our plans and our words. And like the things that we say we're gonna do, we follow through on, and it's like I didn't really have that self-trust before. I think that I think I had a really distorted self-image, but I so didn't realize it was distorted. I think that I had internalized other people's distorted view of me and of us. I saw all these qualities in myself that were all the things we were gaslit with by abusers. I'm starting to see that they are actually just like not accurate for who we are and who we think we are. Is accurate. Like, we're actually capable of doing the things that we talk about and we say we're gonna do, and we are actually we are actually doing them and they are actually working. They are actually going the way that we thought they could. We are actually doing every single bit of the really hard, moment by moment, real behind the scenes work to achieve the real, very slow, very day by day, gradual results that my brain's been going, no, that's just performative. Nah, you're not really doing that, about for ages. And I'm just starting to see how much bullshit all of that imposter syndrome stuff is. It's an amazing moment, really, to see it and to like actually properly believe it and feel it, instead of like seeing it and knowing it on a cognitive level, but like not being able to see it in all parts of me or not being able to feel it in a felt sense. It's like, it's really different to be able to like consistently see and feel it through all parts of me. And maybe that's what this is. Maybe part of the reason that I felt so fake and so inconsistent wasn't just the way we were raised and the stuff that was internalized from the distorted perceptions that were projected onto us by abusers. But maybe it was also partially because I didn't have an alternative view of myself to combat their distorted and inaccurate view with, because every single part of me didn't have like contact with other parts, or most parts didn't have, and whenever we did, be seeing through this lens of like judgment and self-criticism, and I didn't really have a sense of self, so I couldn't like, just like I was invisible to myself, like I didn't feel myself in my body or like the vibe of who I am, or like, and we'd rapid switch around with so much amnesia that I didn't have any continuity or any like idea what I'd done all day or yesterday or the week. So it's like I wasn't ever seeing what I did. I was so disembodied. I couldn't feel any physical sense of self that was so dissociated and depersonalized that it's like it felt like there was nothing, no one there, no memory card to write onto, like there was no file for saves to be stored, there was nothing. Like every fucking moment, I just felt like the beach by the edge of the sea with every single wave washing away every footprint of everything I'd just done, and I wouldn't even notice it happening because the sense of who I was would keep changing. It's like perpetual fucking Groundhog Day, but without the like, I'm not the observer watching the film, I'm not the, in some ways I guess some parts of me were, but I wouldn't be like seeing the footprints get washed away. I would be the sand, feeling it get washed from my fucking surface every time, so I wouldn't remember there'd ever been 1,000 footprints there before. There was like no action and memory and emotion stayed, because as like in survival mode, it felt like the record function just wasn't on, like a permanently shaking etch-a-sketch. And like nothing I do felt like it landed or logged or stayed in me. It wasn't observed, it wasn't witnessed, it wasn't remembered, because I wasn't here to witness it. And like my memory wasn't recording, because it's like I wasn't even in the present, I was most of the time just in flashbacks.
then
as amnesia reduced, it's like some things were made easier, but the feeling of being like fake has persisted a long time, because I'd watch back a vlog and I'd see me, but not me. I'd see our body and maybe kind of similar to my style, saying things that I didn't have any memory of saying, and a lot of the time that I didn't really resonate with, because different parts of me could hold such different viewpoints and beliefs and thoughts. So I'd like watch something I didn't remember saying, which made it really difficult to even like watch back, especially in host parts of me. And then I'd be like, I don't believe in what I'm saying, I believe the opposite, or I believe something in between, or I believe something completely different, or like I haven't even thought about it that much, I'm not attached to it, and like I just couldn't connect with what I was hearing and seeing myself say, and I couldn't really register it as me. And then it's like between that and having been gaslit your whole life and taught that you're wrong and everything you believe is inaccurate, so that your abusers can create somebody who will not be able to fight for their reality or will not be believed when speaking about it. Like, you know, that happens your whole fucking life, and even my grasp of like what I believed and what I felt wasn't something I could always see or connect to in a lot of parts of me. And then that makes you feel like a liar as well, because it's like, well, I don't fucking feel like, I don't even know what I feel. I'm so disconnected from what I feel that like it doesn't feel like I do. And then things have changed and improved, and we've got like better connection between so many parts. Been able to like feel like there's a connection's built, I'll be like, yeah, I remember saying this, but without the emotional attachment, like I feel different about what I'm watching myself say now, even though I remember saying it, and I can't quite understand why I said it or why I felt that way then. And then the more we've worked to gain connection between parts, it's increased and improved even more, so now it's like I can kind of feel and see what I'm saying in different parts of me and connect with it, even when it's across a broad and very different spectrum of different things. Feel multiple different ways, like there's a bit of a sort of flow to it. Sometimes on some things I can feel multiple different ways all at once, very simultaneously. Sometimes it's like I can flow between different ways that I feel, I think. But therefore, with that connection, nothing feels like a lie anymore, because feel what I'm feeling, and I can remember saying it and feeling it, and that connection to that authenticity and genuinity, I think that's what I was missing. that made me never feel like I was real or like I was telling the truth about anything. Even though I was at every point telling the truth about it, I just couldn't connect to what those parts of me were feeling or saying, the parts of me watching or remembering. I'm so proud of us. I can kind of see all of this, and then I can see this continuity as well, and I have this trust. Everything isn't just like random foggy void, like eternity of like questioning, you know, will I like do this thing I've planned for? It's like if I plan to do something, I know that I'll be here to do it. And I trust me to do it. And even if there was a part of me that was like through triggers taken out of the dealing with things, I would trust the other parts of me to go, this is important to that part of me, and to get it done. So I can see that there's this like, yeah, see that there's this continuity, and I have this trust that I'm gonna follow through and remember and like be present in what I'm doing and what I plan to do. I don't think I've ever had that before. It's like, it's amazing, it's hitting me that this is all real, this is all core deep, this is all to the marrow of my fucking bones, through all of my fucking atoms, across all parts of me. It's not just like hollow, surface level, for show, any of the things that I'd maybe even just been conditioned to think about how we made plans and did things. I don't think that has ever been how we are. I think it's just a distorted view that I internalized because I couldn't see what or feel what was really there.